Welcome back. We're now on to the very end of 9.2, transport in the phloem. We've already done just about everything. This'll go pretty fast. For some reason, it's a little random, you need to be able to analyze experiments specifically about phloem transport rates using aphid stylets and radioactively labeled carbon dioxide. Let's break this down a little. Essentially, the phloem is thin and moves slowly, which means that for a very long time, when scientists were trying to figure out how long it actually takes sugar to move around the phloem, it was very difficult. It took too long for the measurements to be accurate enough to get real numbers. Now, somebody eventually noticed that we might be able to have a friend in figuring this out. Aphids. Aphids are these little insects. I personally think they're kind of cute. You can see a big one there with two little ones under its legs. And they have these mouth parts called stylets. You can see in the picture on the right how the aphid injects its stylet into the leaf cell through the palisade mesophyll to the spongy mesophyll, where it can actually drink into the water and absorb the sugar from the leaf. Now, it also does this on the stems, where it goes through the epidermis, through the cortex, into the phloem. That's what you're seeing there, in that picture on the right. This aphid drinking straight out of the phloem. Now, a scientist realized that if an aphid injects its stylet into the phloem, and then you, well, kill the aphid by cutting its stylet out, but leaving it in the plant, the phloem will continue to leak out of the stylet. So here you can see a real aphid having injected into a stem, and then those pictures, A, B, C, D, E, show someone cutting the stylet off the aphid, and then phloem dripping out of it. Now, to measure the rate at which sugar was moving through the phloem, someone decided that radioactivity might be the best way to do it. Plants use carbon dioxide from the air to make sugar. So, if you put a plant in an area with radioactive carbon dioxide, it's going to make radioactive sugar. Thus, you'll be able to see how long it takes the sugar to be made to move into the phloem to wherever you put the stylet down the phloem, by comparing a location high up on the stem and lower down on the stem, and timing both, you'd be able to figure out the rate of flow in the phloem. That's all you need to know. This will probably be a data-based question in some sort of IB exam. We'll see when it comes. Here are some citations. Thanks very much, and 9.3 is done. Rest well.